Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Myself, Professor Ravi Kiran Late. Today we will be discussing multiple choice questions with some of the theory part. For today's discussion, we have heat engines. What are the different heat engines will be there, such as Carnot engine, Otto engine, diesel engine, and their efficiencies we will be discussing in theory part. And based on this part, we will be discussing some of the multiple choice questions in the second part of the presentation. So let us start with the today's session. The first thing which we need to discuss is the heat engine. What is heat engine? Heat engine is nothing but it is a device which converts heat energy into mechanical work done. So it is a device which converts heat energy into the mechanical work. Now, the conversion of heat into energy takes place with a certain substance which we call it as a working substance. For example, if we consider a first engine which was came into the practice, that was a steam engine. In case of a steam engine, burning coal is a source, working substance in that case it is a steam which is generated by burning a coal, that is a working substance. And we know that heat flows from a hot body or body at a higher temperature to a body at a lower temperature. In this way, heat flows according to the second law of thermodynamics. It happens naturally. So that phenomenon is utilized in case of an engine. So first engine which was there, for example, it is a steam engine. In case of a steam engine, source of heat, it is nothing but the burning coal is referred as a source of heat which is at a higher temperature, and steam which is prepared with the help of this source, it is considered as a working substance. And this atmosphere which is at a lower temperature as compared to the source, which is a burning coal, that is nothing but the sink in this case. Okay, so now we will discuss a schematic energy flow of any heat engine. We know that naturally heat can flow from higher temperature to a lower temperature. So basically two parts are there in any design of an engine. One is the heat reservoir, which is at a temperature T1, which is a relatively high temperature, and the reservoir, which is cold reservoir, it is at a temperature T2, or really which is at a relatively lower temperature. Okay, now when heat flows from hot region to the cold region, when heat flows from source to the sink or hot region to the cold region, we can convert some part of this heat into the energy. So device which is used for this purpose, that we call it as a heat engine. Okay, so let us say that Q1 is the amount of heat which is taken from the hot reservoir, and let us say Q2 amount of heat it is given to the sink, which is at a lower temperature. So the net amount of heat, which will be Q1 minus Q2, it will be converted into the work. It will be converted into the work. So we are getting some amount of work done. Now, how you decide the quality of that heat engine? It is the parameter which we call it as an efficiency, which is nothing but the output work we are getting to the input energy which is provided. So efficiency can be defined in the form work obtained to the amount of heat given to the system. But we know that initially in this case we had given the Q1 amount of heat, and this Q2 amount of heat is, it was rejected to the sink. Okay, so net amount of heat which is converted into the work, it is nothing but the Q1 minus Q2. So W we can substitute as a Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. So you get 1 minus Q2 by Q1. That is an efficiency of any engine. You can calculate by this formula. Basically, there are two types of engines are there. What are those two types of engines? The first one is the internal combustion engine, and second one is, that is called as a external combustion engine. That nowadays the engines which are using, these are nothing but the petrol engine, which we call it as an auto engine, and the diesel engine. These types of engines, they are nowadays used majorly. But in addition to that one, external combustion type of engine is there, which is nothing but a steam engine. Nowadays no one uses steam engine for this purpose. So in our syllabus now, in our topic of this presentation, we'll be discussing now auto engine and diesel engine in the detail. But prior to going to the auto engine or a diesel engine, let me show you the first theoretical engine, which was proposed by the French physicist Carnot in the 18th century. That is nothing but the Carnot heat engine. It was a theoretical engine which was proposed by this French physicist. It consists of a cylinder fitted with a piston which can move freely without a friction through this surface. And if you consider this cylinder, the sides of these cylinders, these are made up of insulating material, and the base of this cylinder is made up of a conducting material. So this is the cylinder, which is the main part of this here Carnot heat engine. Next part, it is the source, which is at a temperature T1. Insulating stand is there, and sink is there, which is maintained at a lower temperature T2 as compared to the source. Now if you consider a reversible Carnot cycle, it consists of a four operations. What are those four operations? The first operation, it is an isothermal expansion in which this sink, it is placed on the source. It is placed on the source. So as the lower surface of this cylinder and the upper surface of this source, they are both conducting in nature. So the amount of heat will be given by this source to this gas molecules which is enclosed within this cylinder, and the gas will expand isothermally. So it is shown with the curve AB in this diagram. Now second operation, it is there, that is adiabatic expansion. In that case, the cylinder is moved from this source and it is placed on this insulating stand. Now if you consider the upper surface of this cylinder, this sink stand, it is insulating in nature. So there will be no exchange of the heat with the gas molecules inside this cylinder. Okay, so it is an adiabatic expansion. The curve, it is shown in this figure. And the next time this cylinder, it is kept on this sink, which is at a relatively lower temperature, and as these both are conducting in nature, the gas which is enclosed inside this cylinder, it will give some amount of heat to this sink. So it will be an isothermal compression. And in the last step, this cylinder, it will be removed from this sink and it will be kept on this insulating stand. And so as insulating stand, it does not take or give the any amount of heat with the cylinder. So it is an adiabatic compression. This Carnot cycle, it has been discussed in one of my previous lecture in detail. If you want, you can search Carnot cycle in our playlist Heat and Thermodynamics. You will get a detailed discussion about Carnot cycle. Efficiency of the Carnot cycle, it is given by N is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. T1 is the temperature of the source and T2 is the temperature of the sink. That's it for the Carnot heat engine. Now we will move ahead with the auto engine. Now what auto engine it is that we will discuss. Auto engine consists of a piston fitted with a fitted under a cylinder, and the cylinder is that piston is connected with a wheel with the help of crank and shaft. Okay, crankshaft arrangement is there, and that is connected with a wheel. And this, if you consider the cylinder which is fitted, in which the piston is fitted, there are two walls are there, I1 and I2, and spark plug is there. This auto engine which we are considering over here, these are nothing but the petrol engines which we are using in our daily life. This auto engine, it has total six operations. These six operations are shown over here in this diagram. So these six operations are nothing but A0 to A, to B, B to C, C to D, D to A, and again finally A to A naught. These are the six operations. What are these six operations are there? We will be discussing in the detail in the next slides. Prior to that one, let me tell you the efficiency of the auto engine. It is given by eta is equal to 1 minus 1 upon rho c to the power gamma minus 1. What is gamma? Gamma is the it is a compressibility ratio. It's a ratio of specific heat at constant pressure to the specific heat at the constant volume. And this rho c, that is the compressibility ratio, that is Va upon Vb. That is the volume occupied by the gas molecules at the point A, and the Vb is the volume occupied at the point B. That is called as the compressibility ratio. Now if you consider in this diagram, I had shown the four different pictures are over shown over here. What are those four different pictures are suggesting us? First one is when the we are moving from the first part, that is from A0 to A. When we are moving from A0 to A, what happens? This is called as the charging stroke or intake stroke, in which the wheel will rotate in this fashion from this point to this point, and it will take fluid inside the chamber. It will take fluid or the working substance which will be there. In case of an auto engine, it is a petrol plus air. 2% of petrol and 98% of the air, it will be taken inside this cylinder. Okay, it's the space between the piston and the spark plug. In the second operation, which consists of a operation number 2 and 3, which consists of operation 2 and 3, that is from A to B and B to C. It is called as a compression stroke, in which the wheel will rotate from this position to this position. As a result of that, this piston will move in the upward direction. This piston will move in upward direction, and as this piston will move in the upward direction, so that will be the compression. So whatever the working substance, petrol and air, which is taken inside the chamber, it will be compressed. As a result of that, what happens? The temperature of the environment increases, and the fuel ignite with the help of this spark plug. So in the third operation, which we call it as a working stroke or a power stroke, in this, the due to the explosion inside this one, the piston block, it will move in the downward direction. It will move in the downward direction, and the as piston will move in the downward direction, so due to that one, the volume will increase, and that it is shown with the help of this curve CD. Now in the last cycle, further its volume, it will be decreased when this unused gases or unused gases or unused fuel, it will be given to the sink. So this will happen at this point. So it is the amount of heat will be rejected during this process. So in case of an auto engine, it is the curve we see during which heat is taken inside the system, and it is the curve here during which the heat will be rejected to the sink. And in the final, from A to A naught, from A to A naught, which we call it as an exhaust stroke, the amount of the system, the cycle will regain its original position and the cycle completes. These are the six operations which are involved in this auto engine. Now, next type of engine is there, that is called as a diesel engine. What is diesel engine? Diesel engine consists of the similar kind of arrangement which is there in the auto engine. Just one difference is there. In auto engine, there were spark plug was provided, but in case of a diesel engine, you don't need a spark plug. We'll be discussing that, why spark plug is not required in this one, during the multiple choice question sessions. So diesel cycle, it is shown over here, which also consists of a six operations. The operation 1, that is A0 to A, operation 2 from A to B, operation 3 from B to C, operation 4 from C to D, operation 5 from D to A, and the finally the exhaust operation, it will be there, which is from A to A0. Now see, all these operations we'll discuss in the detail over here. In the first operation, the fluid will be taken inside, or the gases or working substance, it will be taken inside the chamber. During the second phase, it is the compression stroke, in which the volume of the fluid or the fuel which is there, it will be compressed, which is operation number 3. In the third case, which is a working servo stroke, there are three operations are there, from B to C, C to D, and D to A, in which the system will follow this kind of a curve. And in the final step, in the final step, from A to A naught, whatever the unused gases will be there, that will be ejected out, and the cycle completes. Now we will see what is the comparison between the diesel engine and the auto engine. Now see, in case of a diesel engine, it is a oil which is used as a fuel, where in auto engine it's a petrol or combustible gases are used for a fuel purpose. Generally in diesel engine, oil is injected separately with the help of pump, but in case of auto engine, no pumps are required. Petrol and air, it is admitted directly as a mixture in this auto engine. Heat during an diesel engine, it is absorbed during an isobaric process. Remember this, during an diesel engine, heat is absorbed during an isobaric process, whereas heat is rejected during an isochoric process. In case of an auto engine, heat is absorbed during an isochoric process, whereas heat is rejected also in during a isochoric process. We will see this in the cycle as well while discussing the multiple choice questions. Next, adiabatic compression causes the ignition in case of a diesel engine, because we had seen no spark plug is used in case of a diesel engine, whereas in case of an auto engine, electric spark plug is used, and which provides a ignition. In diesel engine, the compression ratio is large, whereas in case of auto engine, the compression ratio is very small. If you consider the danger of explosion in case of diesel engine, it has relatively low danger of explosion, whereas in case of, as the combustible gases or petrol is used, so it has high risk of a explosion. In case of a diesel engine, these types of engines are very heavy and bulky. They are not portable devices, whereas the auto engines are little one or lighter in size and shape, and they are portable. You can transport from one point to the another point. So, and if you consider from the efficiency point of view, diesel engine have a high efficiency as compared to the auto engine. Now that was the theory which we wanted to discuss. Now we will discuss the some of the important multiple choice questions based on the theory which we have considered. Now first question is, a heat engine is a device which converts heat energy into, option A, mechanical energy, option B, electrical energy, option C, sound energy, option D, chemical energy. Now just during the starting of this lecture only, we had seen heat engine is a device which converts heat energy into the mechanical work. So if you look into the option, it is the option A which suggests it is the mechanical energy. So heat engine is a device which converts heat energy into the mechanical energy. So in this case, the correct option is the option number A, mechanical energy. Next multiple choice question is, the efficiency of Carnot engine does not depend upon, option A, temperature of source, option B, temperature of sink, option C, nature of working substance, option D, none of these. Now see, efficiency of a Carnot heat engine, it is given by the formula eta is equal to T1 minus T2 upon T1, where T1 is the temperature of the source, which is given in the option number A. T2 is the temperature of the sink, which is given in the option number B. So if you consider the efficiency of a Carnot engine, it depends upon the T1, which is the temperature of the source, okay, and it depends upon the T2, which is the temperature of the sink. So in question, as it is asked, the efficiency of Carnot engine does not depend. So it is the nature of the working substance on which the efficiency of a Carnot engine does not depend. So it is the option number C, nature of the working substance on which the efficiency of the Carnot engine does not depend. Now, next question is, the self ignition temperature of diesel oil is dash dash as compared to petrol. Options are given over here, higher, lower, same, varies. Answer for this question is obviously lower. Now, first of all, we'll try to understand what is self ignition temperature is. Self ignition temperature is the lowest temperature at which a fuel will ignite without providing an electrical spark, without providing an electric spark. In case of a diesel, the self ignition temperature is 210 degrees Celsius, whereas in case of diesel petrol, it varies from 247 to 280 degrees Celsius. Now, temperature of fuel air mixture in diesel engine running at 1:20 compression ratio, and this compression ratio can give a temperature of around 700 degrees Celsius. As this temperature is much higher than the self ignition temperature of the diesel, which is 210 degrees Celsius. So due to that one, the diesel can catch fire easily, okay? Or self ignition temperature, this temperature, due to the compression, the temperature of the mixture, it will be above self ignition temperature. So due to that one, you don't require a spark plug in case of a diesel engine. Whereas on the contrary, in case of a petrol engine, you have a lesser compression ratio. The compression ratio is generally 1:10 to 1:8, and this does not provide that much amount of temperature, that much self ignition temperature, okay, for a petrol. So due to that reason, it is the spark plug which is used for the in case of an auto engine or petrol engine for the purpose of ignition, okay. So in this case, if you consider this question, the self ignition temperature of the diesel oil is much lower than the petrol, okay. It is a 210 degrees Celsius. Fourth and multiple choice question is, efficiency of Carnot engine is 100% only when option A, sink is at 100 degrees Celsius, sink is at absolute zero, sink is at room temperature, sink is absent. We know that efficiency of Carnot engine, it is given by eta is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. T1 minus T2 divided by T1. Now what I'll do, I'll divide this T1, I'll give this denominator to each of the numerator. So if I do that one, this T1 can cancel with this T1, and so it will be 1 in this case. So it will be 1 minus T2 upon T1. Now if you consider, in this case, it has been asked to us, what is the condition when you will get a 100% efficiency. If we need to have an 100% efficiency, then this second term has to be 0. And this can be possible only when this T2 will be 0. So that means T2 is the temperature of the sink. So temperature of the sink has to be zero, at absolute zero. So the correct answer for this question is the option number B. Next multiple choice question is, in Carnot cycle, work done by the gas in adiabatic compression, these are the options which are given over here. We know that work done during an adiabatic expansion is given by W is equal to R T1 minus T2 upon gamma minus 1. As it is an adiabatic expansion, we need to find out a work done for an compression. We know that during an compression process, the work done is just a opposite, that is a negative of the expansion. So in this case, if I do the give the negative sign to this one, so in this case, the work done during an adiabatic compression, it will be the option number D, minus R T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. Sixth question is, thermal efficiency of the heat engine is given by the equation option A, 1 minus Q2 by Q1, Q2 by Q1 minus 1, Q1 by Q2 minus 1, 1 minus Q1 by Q2. We know that a thermal efficiency of any engine, it is nothing but the output we are getting per unit input. Okay, so in this case, we know that any kind of a heat engine, it takes some amount of heat from the heat reservoir. So let us say Q1 is the amount of heat which is taken from the heat reservoir, and minus Q2 is the amount of heat which is given to the cold reservoir. So in this case, the net heat which is converted into work, it is Q1 minus Q2. So you can write down the efficiency, that is work obtained divided by the amount of heat provided, that is W upon Q1. But W is nothing but the Q1 minus Q2. So if I substitute it in this one, now what I can do, I can divide this Q1 to each of these term, Q1 and Q2. If I do this, it will be Q1 divided by Q1 and this Q2 divided by Q1. This Q1, Q1 will get cancel each other. So you will get 1 minus Q2 by Q1. So that is nothing but the option number D in this case. The correct answer for this question is option number D. Next question is, in diesel engine, heat is absorbed during option A, isothermal process, option B, adiabatic process, option C, isobaric process, option D, all of these. Now in our theory part, we had seen a diesel engine, it has this cycle. If you consider, in case of a diesel engine, heat is absorbed during this process. During the curve BC, heat is absorbed. If you consider from B to C, that is VB to VC, the volume of the system remains, volume of the system increases from this point to this point, but the pressure at this point, these two points remains same at this point. So it is, the pressure is constant during this process, and we know that the pressure, if the process during which pressure is constant, such a kind of process is called as a isobaric process. So the correct answer for this question is the isobaric process, option number C. Next question, in petrol engine heat is absorbed during isothermal process, adiabatic process, isochoric process and isobaric process. Now we know that in case of a petrol engine, the heat is absorbed during this process BC, and if you consider during this BC, B and C, the pressure of the system remains constant, but it is the volume which is remaining constant at the point B. So if you consider, the pressure is changing but volume is remaining constant. So the process during which volume remains constant, we know that that process is called as a isochoric process. So the correct answer for this question is that it is the process, isochoric process, during which petrol heat engine absorbs a heat, option number C. Next question is, in diesel engine or auto engine, heat is rejected during isothermal process, adiabatic process, isochoric process, isobaric process. We know that in case of an auto engine or a diesel engine, heat is rejected to the system during the curve dA. And during this process, if you see, it is the volume which is remaining constant. In this case, pressure is changing from this point to this point, but volume remains constant. And we know, all of us know, that if the pressure is remaining constant, if volume is remaining constant, then it is the isochoric process. So the correct answer for this question is isochoric process. Last three questions which we have discussed, it tells us that in case of an auto engine or a diesel engine, the heat is absorbed during the different processes. But in case of an auto engine or a diesel engine, the heat is rejected during a same process, and that is nothing but the isochoric process. That you have to remember, that what question is exactly asked during the exam. That's it for the today's session. I thank you all students for attending the sessions. I request all of you to please like and comment in the videos, and if you have not subscribed our channel, please, I request all of you to please subscribe, and please share this content with your friends from the other colleges. Okay, that's it for the today's session. We'll stop here for the today's lecture. Thank you.